secret world you visit when you sleep. Strange figures, strange faces, creatures that haunt our nightmares. Sometimes we watch them, and sometimes they watch us. Did you ever dream of being stared at, pursued by evil eyes, with no escape, no place to hide? Have you ever dreamed that you were flying, flying into strange places, far beyond the worlds we know? Yeah, that's it. Fly. Fly. Maybe you can get away after all. Fly. Fly. No. There's no escape. Now you're falling. Falling. And they say if you ever complete that fall in the dream, you'll be dead. There's death in your dreams, too. Death and blood. And the realm beyond death. The realm of eternity. Do your dreams foretell the future? Men have always sought to understand the language of your sleeping mind. Once they were called fortune tellers. Today, we have psychologists. But the dreams are always the same. Full of meaning and menace and mystery. When you dream, you wander into another world. Where everything is strange and terrifying. A world that exists only at night. When you dream, you become a nightwalker.
Quite tall, about 6 feet. Blue eyes, hair, black. Good looking, very attractive to women. Am I right?
Is that why it was so important to see me here this evening?
You forget. I can't see you.
I'm sorry, sir.
So am I. That's the reason I asked you the question.
You're getting it.
You're quite a romantic fellow, Barry. You'll probably appreciate this.
Sure you realize this after his conversation. We must take very good care of him.
My job is to handle his legal interests, Mrs. Trent.
And he pays you
yes. You married a very rich man.
Would you believe it if I told you that money wasn't the real reason?
No, I wouldn't.
Believe what you please. I couldn't care less. But let's get one thing straight. You call yourself a lawyer. Where's your evidence? Would you convict me of cheating on my husband just because I talk in my sleep?
Who is the other man, Mrs. Trent?
Don't you know? He just told you. It's you, Barry. You're the other man. The two of us are having an affair.
This is ridiculous.
Is it? My husband doesn't think so. You're the only man that ever comes here, the only man I ever see.
Truth! Tell me the truth!
All right, here's the truth! My lover is
Irene! Irene!
Thank you. Good morning, Mrs. Quinn. I was expecting you. I was in another office.
Oh, well, I'm interrupting. Your secretary said to come right in.
It's your first time here, isn't it?
First time.
I'm glad you came, my dear. Sit down. I was just going through some of your husband's files. It's quite a lot of property, you know.
That's what I came to talk to you about. Barry, I want to sell the house.
I'm afraid that's impossible. It'll be at least 6 months before the estate goes through probate.
I can't wait 6 months.
Well, Irene, if it's money you need, I'm sure the court would make arrangements for a widow's allowance until the estate's settled.
I want to get rid of the house now.
Why? The building inspector sent a copy of his report. There's no danger in your living there.
You haven't had my report yet. Last night, I dreamed about Howard. I saw the smoke, heard the explosion. I went into the room. The side of his face was burned. Oh, Barry, it was horrible. I don't want any more of those nightmares. If I can't sell the house, I'm moving out today.
Where would you go?
Well, I still own the beauty shop I operated before Howard and I were married. There's an apartment in the back. I used to live there. I think I'd like to stay there for a while.
Would you be comfortable there?
Oh, yes. Yes, quite comfortable.
It's a good idea. At least you'd be working, be out of that house, back into the real world again.
Well, that's all I'm interested from now on. In reality.
Something wrong?
Where did this come from?
I found it in his files. I'd like to keep it.
Thank you.
Was I talking in my sleep? No, but you were a little restless. I've been looking in on you all morning. Morning? What time is it?
11 o'clock.
You must have been very tired. You should have called me. What about the appointments?
It's all right. I took care of them for you. Oh, and I made you some coffee.
You said yourself that was only a dream.
Barry, that's just it. I don't know anymore. It all seems so real.
I mean, you're not making sense. I think it's about time you talked this whole thing over with a doctor. Let me make an appointment for you.
You're telling me you think I'm crazy?
Irene, listen to me.
It was after 12 when I went to bed.
When I'm with you, time stands still.
tell me where we're going.
I'll do better than that. I'll show you.
We have gathered here to celebrate one of life's highest moments. This is indeed a joyful occasion when two people become as one, and we all rejoice with you. Remember this moment. Treasure it for all its beauty. Through the years, it will become a happy memory. And now, it is time to proceed with the ceremony. It joins you both in the joys of matrimony. Do you have the ring? The witnesses are assembled. Do you take this woman to be your love, wedded wife?
I do.
Do you, Irene Trent, take this man to be your lawful wedded husband? I now pronounce you man and wife.
Good morning. Is there something I can do for you?
Yes, is Mrs. Friend here?
I'll see. Joyce!
When do they start to build?
There's somebody here for Mrs. Trent. I'll see if she's in. May I have your name?
Mary Morland.
Yeah, don't you go away, dear.
It's a long corridor just like this. And the light fixtures, well, they look like candles. And the number, if I can remember correctly, it was 341. Now I know it wasn't a dream. What was it? There were paintings on the wall last night. The furniture wasn't covered. It all looks so different, so unlived in.
Of course. What did you expect?
But the apartment is real. I didn't dream it.
Irene, didn't you know that Howard owned this apartment building?
Yes. Number 341 was always vacant. Mr. Trent kept it that way. Now you ought to know that, Mr. Morland. I always send the rent checks to your office every month.
That's right. You're quite sure you've never met this lady before?
Never had the pleasure.
But surely you remember the young man I told you about.
Sorry. I'm afraid not. When I see a man, I remember him. Dear sweetie. What did you say his name was?
Never mind. Irene, did anyone see you this way last night?
No, they were all wax figures.
Wax figures? What are you talking about?
Well, the place where we were married.
Married?
Sounds like you were dreaming, honey.
You say you were married. What was the man's name?
I don't know.
His name would be on the marriage license. Surely you have a license.
I never saw the license. My husband must have it.
You know, I have dreams, too, almost every night. dance and we dance to the most beautiful music. And when I wake up in the morning, my feet hurt.
I think I remember something. The wedding, it was in a strange sort of chapel. And after it was over, the young man disappeared. I tried to get out. And suddenly Howard appeared.
My cousin used to have the most horrible nightmares. She'd wake up screaming. It got so bad, they had to take her away. Poor Clara. She was still screaming.
I suppose you think I'm like poor Clara. Perhaps you better take me away before I start screaming.
Thanks for the information.
No trouble at all.
Take it easy, Irene. There just has to be an answer to all this.
What answer?
Well, you say you went to a chapel after you left here last night. Do you remember where it was?
After I drank the champagne, I felt dazed, as long as though I had been drunk. I somehow have the feeling that it wasn't very far from here.
Do you remember going in a car? Suppose we just drive around slowly.
Try and find a nightmare in the daytime.
Familiar?
I'm positive we came this way. Turn here, I think I see something. This morning it was gone.
You woke up. Irene, don't you see? You've just answered my question.
Then answer mine. If I was dreaming, why is that apartment so real? And how could I find this chapel if I've never been here before? Now somebody brought me here. Why don't you believe me? Barry, I get... off my finger, but he did give it to me. I don't know.
Wait a minute. The band. Irene, did you know that Howard once had you followed by a private investigator?
Oh, no.
Well, he didn't tell me either, for obvious reasons. But a few days ago, I was going through some of his papers, and I came across this bill from a detective agency. It's a man's name, Fuller. George Fuller.
Barry, do you think that might be the young man?
Take it easy. One thing at a time. Let me take this. I'll see what I can find out. Something else I want to check on, too. Do you have a key to Howard's house?
Yes.
Could I take it?
Why do you want it?
I think it may be the key to your nightmares.
Thank you.
Good evening, Irene's Beauty Salon.
I'd like to speak to Mrs. Trent, please. It's very important.
I'm sorry, she's not here now.
You expect her back soon? Would you please tell her that Mr. Moreland called? I'll call again in a little while.
What to believe or who to trust. dreams. No, I won't go to sleep. How can I? Supposing he comes in the night.
Who are you talking about?
Howard!
Mrs. Trent, you just told me your husband died in an explosion.
Why doesn't Barry call?
I don't know. Please, you must get some rest.
No, I won't. I can't.
But you must go to sleep.
Joyce, I am so frightened.
Do you want me to stay here with you?
Would you? Would you please? Just until Barry calls.
Of course. But you must try to get some rest. I'll be right here.
murdered him.
And took his place.
But why?
For Howard's money. He left a will, leaving everything to you. But blind men can't read. So I wrote my name in as the beneficiary. He never knew the difference. But George Fuller did.
That detective, he was in on it?
George Fuller is a fool. He saw me come here to the laboratory the night of the explosion. Tried to blackmail me. But you came to my rescue.
Me?
Yes, you and your silly dream of a young lover. We made a deal to use that dream to get rid of you.
And the nightmares began.
You're truly a remarkable woman, Harry. Anyone else would have been driven out of their mind. You didn't break.
here. Now's the time for a bite of cheer. A tasty light when the price is right. Well, look at here, you'll dig the sight. The moment's handy for a piece of candy. Just name your brand, they're all so grand. Hey, what do you think of a nice little brand? Or a big box filled with a popcorn frill? Let's taste what's meat with an ice cream treat. Refresh yourselves, it's time to eat. So come on, folks, let's join the band as we all head for the big fresh man.
Everyone loves a mystery. Here are two of the best of this or any year combined on one suspense-packed program. Brainstorm, the most fiendish idea ever conceived by the human mind.
What goes on inside the head of a crazy man? Are there explosions? Color flashes?
Jim, don't! That's exactly what he wants you to do. He wants you to attack him. Please, I beg you, let me kill him.
You end up in prison for life, or maybe the gas chamber.
He's got to die.
Jeff Hunter, Anne Francis, Dana Andrews, Vivica Linfors, in Brainstorm. A new dimension in psycho suspense. And this is Ellen Garth, the woman who wouldn't die. You unmask her terrifying secret. Double mystery event of the year. Brainstorm and the woman who wouldn't die.
Look, he's gunning for trouble. 007, it spells bomb. He's the idol of every woman.
Who are you?
Bond. James Bond.
The envy of every man. The nemesis of the treacherous Mr. Goldfinger. Cinema entertainment. A three-time winner for Ian Fleming's Secret Agent 007.
Who are you?
My name is Pussy Galore.
Isn't it customary to grant the condemned man his last request?
You've asked for this.
Come and purr over Honor Blackman as Pussy Galore. The female who is all Eli. Also starring Dirk Rova as Goldfinger, international cheat, international menace.
Gentlemen!
Goldfinger, why weren't we told that New York and the West Coast were in on this?
Goldfinger, I made a delivery. Where is my money?
And you owe me $1 million.
Goldfinger, the man with a finger in every golden pie. His goal, Fort Knox, the world's biggest bank. His enemy, 007, the world's wiliest, toughest gentleman agent with a license to kill. 007, it spells Bond. James Bond, mixing business with girls and thrills. Girls and fun. Girls, the hotter the danger, the cooler.
I think you've made your point, Goldfinger. Thank you for the demonstration.
Choose your next witticism carefully, Mr. Bond. It may be your last.
Do you expect me to talk?
No, Mr. Bond, I expect you to die.
Get out of here!
you up to this?
They call her Jody, but her real name is Trouble. She's blonde, green-eyed, only 17.
Well, am I terrific?
She's irresistible.
That's when I start screaming rape.
She's frightening.
I'll get my claws into you before anyone gets here.
She's defiant.
Oh, you're so eager!
She's Anne Margaret as Jody Dvorak, a special kind of dog. Don't wind her up, or she'll hook her claws into you just as she hooks John Forsythe in Kitten with a Whip.
David, what was that? It sounds as if the house is falling down.
What is the whip hand she holds over his home, his marriage, his life?
You're insane. Who'd believe you?
A girl under 18, running scared, a fugitive. But you take her in, sure. You tuck her into bed, you give her money, you buy her clothes. For what? Because you're a dirty creep whose wife is out of town.
She uses her sex like an animal uses teeth. And every luscious inch of her itches for excitement.
Get your foot off that pedal!
Okay, but step on it. We've lost it. We can't stop now.
Oh, yes, someone's behind her. And... David? Is there someone else in the house?
What?
Dig the cats the kitten runs with. Ron doesn't dig all that jazz about love. Midges hit the boys. Loves a party party.
Hey, Ron, buddy, any swapping goes on. Can we both decide?
Buck switched to razors for kicks. Straight razors.
Sensational new group, the Walker Brothers. How can you blame these beach bunnies for flipping out?
Come on, guys, pick up the tempo. Well,
yeah, swing, little birdies. They're skydiving. It's the only way to fly. They're surfing, hanging ten, and riding the big nine. They're skin diving. They're racing in the Riverside Rally. And the sweetest little streamlined baby of them all, a Silhouette. The hottest D-Long Wheels. It's got Ed Burns, Chris Noel. And guest stars, the Supremes, the Four Seasons, the Righteous Brothers, the Hondells, the Walker Brothers. Nine great song hits. And Beach Ball, catch it.
Project invaded by monstrous creature never before seen on Earth.
Dr. Wyman, half his head's gone.
A ghoulish fiend that feasts on our scientists. A galaxy giant that bullets cannot stop. Night of the Blood Beast. With She-Gods of Shark Reef. Using underwater horrors to hold island beauties imprisoned by fear of voodoo witchcraft. Polynesian girls dancing dreams of love. See their strictly taboo underwater romance. See a young girl fight a killer shark. See She-Gods of Shark Reef in beautiful color and Night of the Blood Beast.
It's intermission. Rise and stretch time. Time to refresh yourself and visit our snack bar. Got a yen for hot popcorn? Your favorite soft drinks are sparkling cold. The juicy Frank sizzling hot. There's delicious coffee freshly brewed. And all kinds of ice cream and candy to tempt you. Showtime will be announced loud and clear to get you back to your car in time. So stretch your legs. Come to the snack bar now. It's time to stretch and fetch. See what's cooking at our refreshment counter. You'll find your favorite foods and beverages, plus many new goodies to tempt your appetite and add to your evening's pleasure. Everything's the finest quality. So treat yourself now. To go to showtime. Popcorn rich with hot melted butter. All kinds of candy. Sparkling soft drinks. Steaming hot coffee. Steamed or grilled hot dogs. Crispy hot fresh French fries. Eight minutes to go to showtime. To go to showtime. Hot popcorn, just pop. Fresh roasted peanuts. How about a pizza? None better anywhere. Sizzling hamburgers grilled to your taste. We've a large assortment of freshly made sandwiches. Six minutes to go to showtime.
I'm sorry, sir. This is a private mountain.
But I only wanted
it. This mountain is reserved for patrons of drive-in theaters.
But
it's a supply depot for all sorts of good things, which people can get at the snack bar, like soft drinks, hot dogs, good hot coffee, candy bars of all kinds, delicious popcorn, and refreshing ice cream treats.
But I am a patron of this drive-in.
Well, why didn't you say so? Be our guest.
Sorry you missed your chance to enjoy some of the many tempting goodies waiting for you. Stretch your legs now while the stretching's good. There's still time to get a mouth-watering hot dog, a sparkling ice-cold soda, assorted flavors of ice cream, all kinds of candy, the most delicious steaming hot coffee you ever drank, and freshly popped popcorn piping hot. Make a beeline for the snack bar right now to quench your thirst. Snack bar. Still time if you hurry. Last call for refreshments, folks. Go right this second to get something good to eat and drink to enjoy now or during the rest of the show. The finest quality ingredients are in the fixings of the delicious foods you'll find waiting to tempt your appetite at the snack bar. Extra special good hamburgers, wonderful donuts, ice cold, thirst-quenching drinks. pizza, generously sliced, steaming hot, fresh coffee, ice cream in many flavors. It's showtime, folks. Enjoy the show.
I can't stand it anymore.
Be patient. When I'm through, we'll get some. How about Isabella?
We had a quarrel. Damn her! She even took what I had.
Try to hold out. We'll find some for sure. Please hold out. Please. Go now.
Okay. Later. Okay. Goodbye.
The sign seems to have come off again. Want me to fix it?
No. No, not today. You can do it tomorrow. Listen, Isabella hasn't turned up again. I don't know what to do with that girl. This is the third time.
All I suggest is a penalty. Make her pay a fine.
It's all very well. The next time she does it, I'm going to fire her.
Good night, madam.
Good night. Nicole, look at this dress. I wish you'd take care of the things you wear. Tomorrow's the show. Now look at this.
Yes, madame, I'm sorry.
Yes, you are sorry, especially when it's time to leave. You have absolutely no mind for anything else.
What does she expect? I'm not in mourning like her.
Poor thing, she hasn't been the same since her husband died.
How long were the lights out?
About 10 minutes.
How long has the girl worked for you?
About 2 years.
Well, what was she like?
She was rather lively. Perhaps lacking discipline. Nothing seriously wrong with her.
Did she have many friends?
Well, Inspector, I'm afraid I can't be of much help to you. I suggest you ask the two girls to live with. Christina Como, the owner of our salon.
Good morning.
Good morning. But we've already met, haven't we?
Oh. Oh, yes. Yes, I think so. After my husband's death.
I remember. The car accident. You certainly can help me. You surely know everything about these girls.
Inspector, I don't run a boarding school. When the girls finish here, they're free to go and do as they please. Well, now, I'll be in the studio. If you'll excuse me.
Please.
You say you went outside to repair the metal sign. At what time was it?
About 7. Madame Christina complained that the noise got on her nerves. So I went out, and I put up the sign again, but I came back inside at once.
Mr. Marlin, I demand an explanation. I hardly put my foot inside the gate when these two grabbed a hold of me.
Ask the inspector.
Inspector?
Calm down and tell me why you're here.
Allow me.
Marquis Richard Morel of Castle.
All right. Now answer my question.
He's here to see me. He's my fiancé.
Why are you laughing?
Because I live with him.
Did you know Isabella?
Isabella? You introduced me to her, didn't you? Yes, I can say I knew her. Only slightly, though.
Only slightly. Well, you seem to be the only one who cares.
They were close friends.
The three of you lived together?
Yes, until they...
What was she like? Tell me who your friend went out with.
I don't know.
Leave her alone. Everybody knows who Isabella's lover was.
Who are you?
Cesar Lazar. I'm a dress designer.
What about the other name?
Which?
The name of this lover.
Ascalo, Frank Scalo, the antique dealer.
Police, tell me, where's the inspector?
In there.
Thank you.
Would you excuse me for a moment?
They confirm.
Judge. I see.
Yes, sir.
So, what kind of a relationship was there with Isabel and you?
We were just friends.
Or lovers.
Well, I hope it doesn't become scandalized if I tell you. I don't believe in permanent, exclusive relationships.
I see. Ever seen it before?
No, I don't know. What is it?
Cocaine. It was found in your friend Isabella's house.
Isabella?
You knew nothing about it?
No.
Never mind. However, I must ask you to remain at my disposal. I'll see you later.
This should have been worn by poor Isabella.
Yes, of course.
Who shall I give it to?
Well, let me see. Oh, Peggy, look. Here.
Please, no, not me. No, please. I thought
oh,
that...
Oh, for heaven's sake, stop that. You're going to ruin your makeup. Greta, you model it.
Oh, no. I don't think I should wear it.
Look, don't be so silly.
It carries bad luck, I'm sure.
But, girl, someone's got to model it.
I'll wear the dress.
All right, now.
What a cynic. She doesn't believe in anything.
That's all right. You can go.
Something missing. The brooch. The brooch goes there.
We'll soon put it right. Where is it?
Well, it was Isabella's own. Wait a minute. She kept it in one of the boxes. Let's look for it. Here it is. Isabella kept a diary. This is a gold mine. Listen, he's a man that awakens such deep feelings in me that afterwards I feel limp, empty.
Let me see.
I don't think we should.
Come on, crazy. This is hardly the moment. Be off with you. Go on. Go on and change. This, you know, should be handed to the police.
I found it, if you don't mind. I would like to give it to the police tomorrow.
As you wish.
Hello, Frank. Why haven't you come?
I'm just leaving. But I don't feel well.
I understand. Come out here. I've got something. Listen, Frank. I have found a diary. Isabella's diary.
A diary? Who else?
Everyone was looking. I didn't realize that there might be something about you in it. By the way, I said that I would give it to the police tomorrow.
I'll be right over.
But you are terribly ill, Frank. Frank, can you hear me?
Nicole, I can hardly breathe. If you've got some, I'll feel better. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Hurry up, girls. Greta, you're next. Everything all right, Marco?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Well, Caesar, where have you been?
Right here.
Well, then send them in. Do I have to do everything myself?
Nicole.
You were wanted on the phone.
Me?
Yes, you.
Hello?
Hello. Is that you, Nicole?
Yes. Who's speaking? Can I come now? Well, I will do my best. I will come right away.
All right, hurry up, hurry up.
Frank feels bad. He needs me. I'll have to go over. I can't wait anymore. Please lend me your car.
How are you going to get away? We're right in the middle of a show.
Who cares? Please give me your keys, but don't let anyone see you.
What are you doing?
Nothing. I was looking for a handkerchief. Be careful. Burglar is in the glove compartment right at the back.
Sure. Cover me.
Thank you.
Frank. Frank?
Keep you company till Nicole gets in.
Aren't you afraid in there alone?
Well, to tell the truth, I'm awfully tired. I wanted to go to sleep right away.
But don't you have to wait till Nicole brings the car back anyway? Please.
All right. Come on up.
Thanks. I couldn't have gone off with an easy mind, knowing you were alone in this house.
You're still here.
Good evening, miss. Yes, I've just finished. Miss Nicole hasn't come home.
No, she's gone to a party. She'll be home later. She's always mothering us.
Well, I'll be running along. Oh, I left the dinner heating on the stove. If Miss Nicole wants that meth of hers, she only has to warm it up.
Thank you, Clarice. Good night. See you tomorrow.
Just don't seem to understand.
Of course I...
Peggy, I'm tired of trying to make you understand. I've told you 1,000 times. I've fallen in love with you. I don't care what happens, but...
Calm down. Sit here.
See? I'm not well. I know I look like a fool. That's what makes me mad. I'm ill. I'm lucky.
Don't be like that. I understand you. I'm your friend. Come on, cheer up.
I'll get yours.
Don't touch it! Don't touch it!
What's wrong? I just wanted cigarettes. What's wrong?
I'll get the cigarettes. You're just untidying my bag. Hello?
Good evening, Miss Peggy. This is Inspector Sylvester. I have to ask you something about your car. Your car has been found abandoned. I want to know if it has been stolen.
No, I lent it to my friend Nicole. Yes. Yes. She was in a hurry. A friend of hers called to say he felt ill. But has something happened?
We better talk about this in person. I'll come over and see you right away.
Very well. I'll be waiting.
What's up?
They found my car, but without Nicole. My God, what could have happened?
Is he coming here?
Yes, he wants to talk to me.
Then, I better leave. I don't want the police to find me here.
Yes, it's best. No one knows you've been here.
Yes, for me. And especially for you.
I suppose so.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Peggy trying to steal $1,000 from my purse. She began to cry and explained how much she needed it. She was pregnant and not able to face the scandal. I felt sorry and I loaned her the money. It means that tomorrow I will ask him for $2,000.
Miss Peggy.
Ask you to excuse me. There's no time to be visiting. But it's a rather urgent matter.
Please, make yourself comfortable. Why did you come here? Charles, you may go, please. Well, then?
A little while ago, I found Nicole lying in my shop. She's been murdered.
Oh, my God.
I've gone to the salon to pick up Nicole. Remember? I met you there at the time. I looked for her everywhere. I couldn't find her. Then I went back to my shop. And believe me, I've never seen such a mess.
You'll pardon me. But why have you come here instead of calling the police?
Nicole was my girlfriend. She was murdered in my shop. The police will be accusing me of it. I need an alibi. And you've got to help me.
Me? What have I got to do with it?
Me? You're just as much to blame for it as I am. We've got to tell the police that we're always together at the salon. Right to the end. Back you up, you do the same for me. It's best for both of us.
But you're mad. The police had no reason to accuse me of anything.
You're the one who's in trouble. You really could have killed her. No, no. Call the police at once. Or I'll have to.
All right, go right ahead. But don't forget to tell them about your bad debt.
What debt?
You signed IOUs to Isabella for a loan of several thousand dollars. And couldn't pay the money back.
Is it true? Richard, you never told me. Is it true? My God!
You, my dear Marquis, don't have a single dollar to your name. You're absolutely flat. And afraid of a scandal. Which is a good enough reason for killing Isabella. At the same time, eliminating the possibilities of her diary being read by the police. Who knows? Perhaps a diary had the dates on which the payments were due.
Which diary? I know nothing of it.
Don't lie, Richard. I told you, Nicole had found Isabel's diary.
As you see, we sink or swim together, Mr. Morrell. And if you don't want the police meddling around in your private affairs, I suggest you take my advice. Going back to my shop now and call the inspector. I'll tell him that we were always together. All right. Good evening.
How do you think this girl got in here?
She had a key.
How come?
I'd given it to her. She used to come and see me now and then.
Her too.
Inspector, please don't think that Nicole was the reason why I left Isabella.
And how many other people had a key to your door?
No one else. Except myself, naturally.
Naturally. Did you take drugs with her, too?
Why, what do you mean, Inspector?
Come, Scarlo. Don't try to fool me. You've got the habit. It's written all over your face. If you like, I'll even tell you where you get the stuff. And, as for the girls who shall we say, keep you company, they either try to get you to drop the habit like Isabella, or join you in it, like this one, for example.
All right. Perhaps. But that doesn't make me a murderer. Besides, I've got an alibi. I was with...
I haven't asked you, for the time being. We'll go on with it later.
When?
In my office. Come along.
Down the first number, 453. You can see.
Did you see a man or a woman?
A man, I am sure. He's dressed in black, but he seemed to not have a face.
Perhaps he was wearing a mask.
Perhaps, I don't know. I was distracted by the horn.
Which horn?
The horn of this car, Inspector. I know it. I've serviced it. It blew for a time, and then it stopped.
Has this car got a burglar alarm, Sergeant?
Yes, it's here, in the glove compartment.
How long did it blow?
I don't know. I told you. It wasn't for long.
This long?
Stop. Not longer than that.
If you don't know where it is, it would take quite a while to find it.
We've wasted enough time on this. Let's go to the office. Seen any of them in Miss Peggy's car?
Good morning, Mr. Morland.
Morning, Clarice.
Have you seen him in the car?
Certainly she's seen me before in the car on more than one occasion.
What's so strange about that?
And who said there was? Let's continue.
Him. I've seen him in the car.
Of course she's seen me. What does it prove? This is all so ridiculous.
Be quiet.
You didn't see only me, did you? Open your eyes, you idiot. Look at him. Haven't you ever seen him?
Inspector, do you only want to know if I saw him in the car?
Why?
Because this gentleman came into the flat with Miss Peggy last night.
We're beginning to see the light now.
You swine. What are you getting at? You want to ruin me? I'll kill you! I'll kill you! Why don't you confess? Confess! Confess! You're the murderer! Inspector, look at his face! He hates women! Look at him! He's the killer, I tell you! He's the killer! He killed them all because he couldn't go with any of them! Why didn't you tell the inspector that your wife left you for that very reason? My pills! My pills!
Try to hold him still. He could hurt himself. Take him to the hospital. Didn't any of you know he was an epileptic?
No, I didn't.
You can go home now.
Goodbye, Clarice.
I'm sorry, but I'm afraid I'll have to ask you to stay here, Mr. Morin. You too, Mr. Lazard.
What do you mean, stay here?
I mean I shall have warrants made out for your arrest.
Pardon me, Inspector. What exactly is the reason behind this?
Miss Nicole's murderer had used Peggy's car on other occasions. That's why he knew exactly where the burglar alarm was hidden.
Can I go now?
And me?
No. You both stay too.
But that's ridiculous. I've got an alibi. The Marquis has confirmed it.
It's true. We were together.
Oh, don't worry. I haven't forgotten it. You both were at his house till 11 o'clock, while Miss Nicole was murdered at 10.
So what do you want with us?
Well, when I called Miss Peggy to say that I had found her car, it was about 11:30. About 15 minutes later, I was at her apartment. She wasn't there. And her apartment had been ransacked. Someone could have killed her and hidden her body in the meantime. And as far as that goes, gentlemen, your alibi isn't really worth much.
9 o'clock. Why must we sit in the dark? As if we weren't scared enough already. Do what you want, but please try to keep calm. How are we supposed to keep calm? Doesn't what's happening bother you? I'm frightened too. Don't think I'm not. But getting hysterical doesn't help.
If only the men would come back.
We're all women left alone. Hello? Oh, Mr. Morlan at last. What happened? Don't worry. Bye. They are holding all five of them.
But why?
The police obviously think one of them is the murderer.
I thought so. Madam, please can we go?
Oh, yes, yes, go.
Goodbye. Good night. Good night, madame.
How I envy them. They live together. At least they keep each other company.
I must go, madame.
All right. Wait. Listen, why don't you come home and sleep with me?
What? I live a few yards from here. And you want me to come out into the countryside?
Then I could come and stay at your place.
No, I'm sorry, but I'd rather be alone. Anyway, you'd be even more afraid at my house.
But aren't you afraid? Isabella and Peggy live with you. Isabella's been killed, and Peggy...
Yes, I know. But I don't think anything would happen tonight.
All the men are under arrest. And I'm sure the murderer is one of them.
Goodbye, madame. Good night.
Madame, I'm not going home. I'll sleep here.
No, you won't, dear. You're going home just like the others.
No, I'm all alone. I live out in the country, not here in town.
No, Greta, listen to me. Tomorrow we have a very hard day ahead of us. The show must go on, you know.
Now, Isabella and Nicole were mixed up in some ugly business that has nothing to do with the rest of us. So we have nothing to be afraid of, you understand? Go now. Don't worry.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
Good
Marquis rang to say he'd be detained in town by an engagement.
I know. I'll dine alone.
Immediately, yes.
Just a moment, please. Take care of the rest.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Look at how the murderer tortured her. He must have used a red hot poker. He must have been a madman.
Or a sex maniac in homicidal fury.
Against beautiful women.
Yes. Perhaps the sight of beauty makes him lose control of himself and kill. We'll have to start all over again.
Excuse me, sir. If you want to see the footprints we found in the garden, we're ready now.
Let's look at those footprints.
The killer drove up to here. The footprints show that he started here, got out, and walked up the embankment to the farm. They match the footprints we found at Orland's villa.
Are you sure?
Absolutely. We have the proof in the plaster cast.
I could have sworn that the murderer was one of the five suspects we had.
Do we have to let them go?
Of course. This time they've got a really foolproof alibi. I gave it to them.
Morel, Richard.
That's me.
You want to check it?
Of course I'll check it.
Max Morland.
Mr. Moreland, I'm a calm person. I'm not nervous. But the thought that a sex maniac is prowling around your fashion house, well, I don't like it. I'd like to take a short holiday. I have already booked a flight to Paris for tomorrow.
To Paris? Very well, Phil.
Thank you.
By the way, you still live with the Countess?
Yes, why?
Oh, nothing. Except, a short while ago, while the Count was alive. I visited there frequently. Lovely place. You know, from the terrace, you can see all of Rome.
Yes. I'd rather see the roofs of Paris than London.
I understand. Have a nice time. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Then I had to do something else. I had to get her out of here. To give you an alibi. And then I killed Greta.
Perfect.
Perfectly awful. I don't know how I did it.
As if it wasn't bad enough to find Isabel in the wardrobe.
Oh,
I nearly fainted.
I wanted to tell you about it, but I couldn't. By the way, how did you manage to carry Peggy to Morell's farm?
Well, I didn't. I somehow got her into the car. And Greta did the rest.
Why did you pick on Greta?
Well, she was alone in the house, that's why.
Well done. The police think it's the work of a sex maniac.
If it hadn't been for that damn diary. It is done now, and we have nothing to worry about, my darling. Nothing to worry about.
No, you're wrong. You're wrong. We'll never have any peace until we've given the police their murderer.
Peace?
Chris, listen to me. We'll never get away with it unless they find the maniac they're looking for. Never. Until they do, they'll keep their eye on us. You must remember, all the victims worked for us, but while they have no evidence against us, the whole thing is blown sky high. The press, the scandal, the salon being closed down. Got to find a way out.
What are we going to do? I know, darling. We're going to fly to the moon.
We've got to act again one more time. You've got to do it.
Oh, no.
Yeah. I'm still being shamed. Now, don't worry, darling. We'll find an alibi for you. Now, don't worry.
Oh, no, Max, no. You can't ask me. I can't do it. I can't do it, you know.
You've done it before.
I've done it before. I've done it before, but that was different, you know. Because you're in danger, and I had to do it. Do it because, unless I hadn't done it, everything would have been lost forever. Only my love for you gave me the strength.
Useless!
Useless! Are you surprised to see me alive, Max, my love? Sure, your plan was ingenious. Shop on broke my
feet. Please.
Silence. I know what you planned to say. That you didn't do it. But I know you did. I know you did. Because you knew that I would be passing by the ledge. If there was any danger, remember? Remember, you told me to. You told me to.
Listen to me. You must listen.
Yes. Yes, you had an ingenious plan. If the police found my body, everything would have been solved. Everything. And you would have been free.
Thank you.
And now, folks, it's time to say goodnight. We sincerely appreciate your patronage and hope we've succeeded in bringing you an enjoyable evening of entertainment. Please drive home carefully and come back again soon. Good night.